When we look at objects in astronomy, we're dealing with such a wide range of things that it's hard to get a good perspective of how big something is or how small something is. So this presentation is going to attempt to give you an understanding of the scale of astronomy. So we're going to start with something familiar. The size of a person. We all know how big people are. But what we're going to do is pull back so that we can see how quickly people disappear and even other familiar objects disappear as we work our way out through the universe. So the first thing we see is if we pull back a little bit, we can see an entire neighborhood. In this case, a neighborhood in New York City. People on this scale are going to be quite small, but just on the verge of visibility. Certainly cars are visible in this image. So we're already to a scale where people are not visible at all, but we still see familiar objects. Pulling back a little further, we can see our entire city. So our neighborhood of New York City now gives way to the majority of New York City. On this scale, obviously, people are not visible at all. You might get a hint of cars. Certainly buildings are visible on this scale, but we are getting farther out. Pulling out even farther, we're going to see the entire state of New York. So the city of New York has been shrunk down to a relatively small size over here. And now we can see the entire state. Now obviously this is a drawing, not an actual image. But on this scale, you're not going to see buildings. You'll be able to see where greenery is. You'll get a sense of where cities are, but you aren't going to see much detail. Pull back a little farther, and now our state has become quite small, and we're seeing our entire country. Again, we wouldn't normally see the United States looking like this. You don't see state boundaries from space. But from this perspective, you're not going to see any detail. It's going to be very indistinct. Certainly no people, no buildings, and no detail. Now we're to the point where we can see our entire planet. And normally this is where I would have started, but even just getting a sense of how big our planet is difficult. And so I wanted to provide that initial perspective. So here we see the United States. We see Central America, part of South America. We see Canada, all the way up to almost the North Pole. Obviously, on this scale, country boundaries don't mean anything. State boundaries don't mean anything. You can see where land masses are. You can see where plants are. You can see where ice is. You can get a sense of deserts and certainly oceans. But that's all the detail you're going to see. And yes, cloud patterns. If we pull back a little farther, we are now far enough away from our Earth that we actually see our moon. And if you look at the size, you get a sense of how small the moon is compared to the Earth and how far away the moon is. When astronauts traveled to the moon, it took about 3 days to get there. It's 250,000 miles away. A total of 27 people have made that trip. Not all of them walked on the moon. Only 12 people walked on the moon. Every other human that has ever existed besides those 27, their entire existence has been right here at the Earth. Even those who go to the space shuttle or the International Space Station, they are in Earth orbit, and the line I drew isn't too far off from the largest distance they ever traveled from Earth. So we have had a very limited human existence. We have, for all intents and purposes, we have only been on the Earth with just a very, very small number of people traveling this relatively short distance out to the moon. If we pull out a little farther, our moon is going to disappear. It's too small. We're not going to see it anymore. We're only going to see the Earth. And again, of course, this is a drawing, but on this scale, the sun will be very visible because it's going to be the bright thing. The three planets in closest to the sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars, are going to appear as tiny dots. This particular image shows them in a line. Odds are they would not be in a line. They would be in different positions in their orbits around the sun. So at this scale, we're not going to be able to see moons even, and planets have been reduced to tiny dots. These first four planets are called terrestrial, which means Earth-like, because they are kind of similar to Earth. They're solid, rocky planets. And so, because they have characteristics that are kind of like us, we call these terrestrials. If we pull out even farther, the terrestrial planet orbits are so close to the sun that at this scale, they're all inside this little circle here. And now we're actually at a distance where we can see the orbits of the outer planets. And these are called the Jovian planets because they're like Jupiter, which is Jove. And so here we've picked up Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Our solar system is essentially the sun and everything that orbits it. So that includes obviously the planets, the moons that go around the planets. Also in the mix, you're going to have asteroids. They're going to be in here between Jupiter and Mars. And comets, which are out here past Neptune. That's also where Pluto would be found. So all of those things constitute our solar system. Sol is another name for our sun. And so solar system is our sun's system. Now we're going to start moving pretty fast, because the next thing we get to are the next nearest stars. Now, pulling out to this scale, all you will see is our sun. The planets have disappeared. They're too tiny, they're too faint. We won't see them on this scale. Our sun is going to look like a tiny dot, very much like what stars look like to us in our night sky. Our sun is a star. And so these nearest stars, we can kind of think of this as our neighborhood. The solar system is like our family. And so these stars, these are within 10 light years of the sun, are our neighbors. These are the ones that are nearby. And you can see there's just a small handful of nearby stars within 10 light years of the sun. Now we've pulled out quite a bit, and our little group of stars have disappeared into the haze. They'd be a tiny, tiny section. That dot is probably way too big. In fact, I know it's way too big. So that's our little area, our neighborhood. The Milky Way galaxy, and this is true for any galaxy, This is a collection of billions of stars. Held together by gravity. So everything you see in this picture, everything in this image here that's giving off light is a star. But there are so many stars that it all just blends together and you see this blur of light. That is a galaxy. So our sun is one of billions of stars. They are all orbiting around the center of our galaxy. We are moving in orbit around the center of our galaxy. So this is kind of like our city. If the nearest stars is our neighborhood, the Milky Way is our city. So the Milky Way is not the only galaxy there is. And if we pull out away from it, we find that we have some neighboring galaxies. And that's called the local group. This is a cluster of galaxies. And our cluster is relatively small. There's about 40 galaxies in our local group. The nearest biggest one is the Andromeda Galaxy, and it is about the same size as the Milky Way. It's probably a little bit bigger. But each one of these little galaxies contain billions of stars. So these are cities near each other. So we could think of this as kind of a metropolitan region, maybe like the Tri-Cities. Bigger cities, though. So our local group is a cluster of galaxies. A supercluster is an even larger group of galaxies. And here we see the local supercluster, the supercluster we are a part of. Now every tiny dot that you see in this image, and there's a lot of tiny dots in this image, is a galaxy. Every one of those galaxies has billions of stars. So here we're just seeing the nearby part of galaxy superclusters. And so you're starting to get a sense of how much is actually out there. And finally, our last stop is the universe. The universe is everything. So this is going to be comprised of innumerable galaxies, each galaxy containing billions of stars. Who knows how many of those stars have planets going around them? The picture we're looking at here is called the Hubble Deep Field. And this image is a part of the sky that is about the amount of sky you would cover if you held a grain of sand at arm's length. And how much sky would that grain of sand cover? In this picture, there are thousands of galaxies. In just that one little grain of sand. Each one of those galaxies has billions of stars. Think about how many grains of sand would cover the sky. If each one of those grains of sand had thousands of galaxies, each one of those galaxies had billions of stars. If most of those stars had planets going around them, that is our universe. That is how big it is. That is how unfathomable it is. There's no way to wrap your brain around it, because it's just getting into numbers that are too big to even begin to make sense out of. And even this tiny little picture, this tiny little sand grain piece of our sky, has so much in it. Thousands of galaxies, billions of stars. You're already dealing with numbers that are humongous and difficult to comprehend. And yet that is what we're talking about when we talk about our universe. So hopefully that has given you a sense of how much is out there and how big the universe really is.